Hello friends, how are you? I hope so that you all would be fine, and I can guarantee that you are at the right place to learn about the pointers in C. So basically in this part of the tutorial, first we would be understanding about the pointers by drawing a memory diagram and then compiling a simple program to make you understand pointers more easily. So let's start. We all know that memory are the places where the variables are stored. It depends on the size of the variable, how it is stored. So just draw a simple assumption of memory in which each block of memory takes 4 bytes of space. And let us name the memory from the downside as 200, 204, 208 and so on, moving upside from the down. Let us declare a variable b of type integer. The size of the variable b would be 4 bytes space in the memory. It can be 2 byte space also, but in my system it's 4 byte. So this system would be finding a place to store this variable. Just let it be stored at 224. It depends on the system where it stores and find a free space. Now let's declare another pointer variable c of type integer. It would be stored anywhere where it finds a free space inside the memory. Let us assume that it is stored at 208. Now, whenever we are going to write an asterisk sign before a variable, then it is known as the pointer variable. And before we start with the pointer, let us know about its definition. Pointer is a variable whose value is the address of some another variable. That is, the address of any another variable would be its value. Now let us see how it works. Now let us write that C equals ampersand B. Oh, it means that the address of B had been assigned to C. And whenever we are going to print the value of C, note I am not printing it using the pointer, simply C, then it is going to print the address of B, that is 224, and the address of B is also 224. So it is what basically there is a location of memory stored inside the variable C. So let us compile a program and understand more easily how does a pointer work. As you can see here that I have already created a program by the name pointer.c and included the important header file, that is standard input std.h, and the main function. Now let us declare an integer b whose value is 5 and then pointer variable c. And now what we are going to do is that we are going to store the address of b to the pointer variable c. It is done using this statement. Now the address stored in the c would be the address of b. So let us check whether it is the same or not. Just print the address of B first is right here. Address of B, and this statement would be printing the address of B. While print, let us see which address had been stored in the pointer variable C. Address stored in C, line break, comma, C. Just hit on execute, compile and run. As you can see, the address of B is something here it is given, and while the address stored in C is this. And how are we going to point to this variable using this pointer C? It is one of the most important thing that we are going to do. This right here, %d value of pointer c. Sorry for the spelling, I hope so you do not mind. This right here, pointer c. So this would be printing the value to which it is pointing, that is 5. When we compile and run the program, we see 5. Here you can see that 5 is printed on the screen, value of pointer c. So this is what basically the pointer does, and it just points to the value of another variable to which its address had been given. So that's all. Just watch my next tutorial. Thank you. So if you liked our video, just hit on thumbs up, subscribe and do share. Thanks for watching. Thank you.